Alors.
Ouais. So anyhow, if you don't close this, then when you open the computer again, before you even log in, you're visible. Obviously, because that's why I didn't enter my password and you said hello.
Yeah, it works right away.
I mean, even if you're not logged in, it works. If you're
Yeah, but all the blankets, they're not logged in.
No, I mean, you're not logged into your computer.
Oh, that's interesting.
I got home, opened my computer. Before I typed in my password, you said hello.
That's a bit creepy.
Means I should remember to close this app. Oof, I rode my bike to work and back today. Was good exercise.
You live close to work then.
Yeah, it takes me about 20 minutes on the bike. It takes me about 10 to 15 in the car. Because there's a lot of there's a lot of stoplights and stop signs and shit. And they're poorly timed, so you might be on the main road and stop a stoplight for this little half little street there that sit there and wait for a long time, nobody's going across the street. But on a bike, you just blow through those stoplights. I pay no attention to traffic laws at all on a bicycle. I'm totally glad I bought that bike. When I bought it, when I got it home, I was like, Eric, you shouldn't have spent that money on this bike. It's not worth it. But I've ridden it a lot, and I feel better. I feel healthier. I feel, like virtuous or something, I don't know. Like, look at me being healthy.
Yeah, but that's normal, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's from me. I don't expect you to read it, but if you do, you will find some interesting facts.
What happened? What? That's not you. Hold on. Oh, I know the answer to this question. It's homogeny. As long as you have a totally homogenized culture with shared values of mutual respect that's driven from individualism, you can implement an actual socialist policy that's not exploited by individuals. However, the problem is most cultures aren't that homogenous. And when you start letting in non-homogenous members of the culture, like Sweden did, you're fucked.
Yeah.
Is that what the article says?
No. It says Norway has shitloads of money and spend less money than the US on social things.
Right. Culturally homogenous, small in terms of population compared to quality and quantity of resources, good
Yeah.
location, located in Europe, EU, like a lot of different factors that allow Norway to get away with what's fundamentally bullshit, basically because they
And
lie to themselves. That's why they lie to themselves.
not part of the European Union.
Oh, okay. Well, they even better.
Yeah.
Even better. I mean, the thing is, yeah, fine,
Can
Norway.
do that shit.
Norway just do whatever the fuck they want. You know why? Norway's not causing anybody any problems.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, look, Norway, we're not trying to, nobody's trying to tell Norway what to do. All
That's
right?
true.
Norway's not a problem child. And so you don't need advice about how to structure your society. If you will eventually, when you get invaded by non-Norwegians, then you have to deal with individuals in the full spectrum of their diversity, which means respecting individual rights over societal goods. Because you're no longer part of one homogenous group, then you've got a lot of diverse individuals.
That may be, but right now it's working well. And we are not Sweden.
Right. You're not crazy about it either, right? So, you're saying we're all reasonable people. Let's have this reasonable, muddied line between our principles, our convictions, and where they conflict and stuff, and not try to be rigid about it. Fine, because you are all reasonable people. Norway seems like a very reasonable place. The one Norwegian I know seems very reasonable. Loki, a little bit less reasonable, but...
yeah.
Because I know two Norwegians.
That's because he doesn't realize how good he has it.
Right. Yeah. Look, if you're in a place where you got it good and shit's going smooth and everything, then there's no reason to worry about it. Everyone gets it. But that's because you guys basically agree with each other.
Yeah. That's not a bad thing.
No, it's not. If that's the side you got, a bunch of agreeable, reasonable people, then you can make compromises and know it's not going to get out of hand. But because I think that I mean, until you need a limiting principle, you don't. If you can get away without a rule, you get away with it. We can't, because nobody makes any kind of reasonable arguments. I mean, your own social policies aren't justified by reasonable arguments, but they're harmless insofar as everyone feels good about it, and it's basically you're paying for feeling good.
Yeah, and we can afford it.
Yeah, you can afford it, and whatever. I mean, who can afford it, though, right?
What do you mean?
I mean, not everybody pays the same in taxes.
Well, that's true.
Okay. I mean, so it seems to work well if you look at it from a macro picture, but if you look at it from an individual who's having their substantial amount of their wealth taken from them, it doesn't look so good. You say, well, Jesus, how much better would Norway be if the government weren't misappropriating half their wealth?
But how are they misappropriating it, considering that they actually spend less per citizen than the U.S.?
Because I'm not comparing it against the U.S., I'm comparing it against an ideal. That ideally we wouldn't have any of our money stolen from us, right? The fact that you get robbed less, or that the government is less stupid than the U.S. government, is a very low bar. Okay, U.S. government is fucking moronic. Being better than the U.S. at something is not something to be proud of.
Okay, but I still like the fact that they try to be very egalitarian.
Right, I know. You guys are paying taxes to feel good.
Yeah.
It costs a lot in actual standard of living and actual total wealth per individual and stuff, because necessarily the government eats 25% of everything they take in terms of administrative costs.